Okay. My session is about digitization and impact. And essentially, this is bringing economic development planning mechanism into heritage digitization projects. The process of turning digital assets into digital resources, and the process of using impact analysis as an aid for securing funding. Impact analysis, in short, is a process whereby you will do a test run or in-depth analysis of what you're going to do and secure impact with your target communities before you actually start your project. And most of the time, yesterday and today, what we're going to see is beautiful work has been done. Now we're going to see how people are communicating with it or realizing it. This is a slightly different, and it's based on a evaluation model which has been developed in King's College London, and it's based on a digitization project of Olympic class of ship drawings in Belfast, including the Titanic last year. So this basically says that the partners were National Museum of Northern Ireland, which is based in Belfast. And we did nearly 200 ship drawings there. The largest one was 6 meters. And the technology came from Kyoto University. Kyoto University has got an extensive selection of displays in the exposition later on this afternoon in the Medieval Museum. And by the way, Medieval Museum is very difficult to find. So if you can't find it easily, I recommend that... is it not visible? Do you want to kill the main light? Is it possible to kill them?
Yeah.
A little bit better? So the work was done using very advanced technology for very large DPIs. I'm not going to play a video, which hopefully will just prepare us. This is the process which allowed us to capture the digitized images. So the assets were made through this process. Because we have in total about 24 people, including paper conservationists, art historians, social scientists, collection managers, and engineers. It was a collaborative project. We had people speaking Japanese, Filipino, English, Irish, and Persian. Digital data in many different ways. You have seen many versions of this, and hopefully when the next 2 minutes finish, the work of people like me will stop? Or in other words, how do we turn these assets into something more satisfactory for the funding agencies? DPI, they are not extrapolated. So 600 DPI to 1200 DPI. Some of the drawings are also multispectral and X-ray. To do and the balancing value impact model developed at King's College London is a process whereby we need to have as accurate as possible understanding of the context, analyze that context and go through the design practice, implement the project, and seek your outcome and results, and review and response. For this presentation, the first three steps are what I'll be concentrating on. So context, which of course it means stakeholder identification and what are your value drivers. Design process. And implementation process. These are very ordinary steps in any project planning. However, when we want to do situation analysis in heritage digitization, we need to look at both the organization, which is the collection holder exhibitor, and the digital resource itself. What are its strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats? The strengths of the digitization that we did was the fact that they were extreme high resolution, and the weakness was that to view them, the technology was not available. The size of the files are so huge that to get the best deal, you need at least 4K projectors or 4K screens, some of which will be at the exhibition this afternoon. The opportunities are immense because City of Belfast celebrated in 2012 the anniversary of Titanic. The threats are also as equally worrying, part of it being that how do you turn a failed ship experience, a sinking ship, into a brand for a city? And the second major threat is that the construction at Holland & Wolff was based on a historical divide between the Catholic and the Protestants. That divide still is bringing social tension to Belfast. So here we have a technologically very rich asset, which might be more of a threat because it will bring back those conflicts to the fore, or it might actually resolve it. I have convinced myself and my colleagues at the museum in Northern Ireland that by using this balanced impact model, we can have enough community involvement in developing that resource. So value drivers are of course social, internal for the institution, economic, and innovative. You are familiar with the various use values. I put exchange value at the bottom, which is the monetized turnover. Funders are focusing on that. The rest of us pretend that you're focusing on many other things, heritage, inheritance value, knowledge value, or the use value, and the project will be looking at community value particularly. We need to know what we want to do, where and when, and how and for who, and who is the essence of our project. Who is the target community, the stakeholder engagement, we need to have the stakeholders both before the resources been launched, at the launch and after the launch. And we'll be using normal development process engagements such as knowledge cafes and focus groups. We'll analyze if there's any need for training of the community members to be able to actually engage with the digital assets and then bring in the participation from the earlier stages. The keywords used here are the keywords that our funders in Northern Ireland are looking for: community education, participation, and ICT. So the process is to turn set of ship drawings and plans, which were done in the offices of Harland and Wolff by the people in their masses, into something which will now bring their engagement. And of course, the journey is all about capturing impact. A measurable outcome arising from the existence of a digital resource that demonstrates a change in the life or life opportunity of the community for which the resource is intended. We have set ourselves a very non-technology driven impact, life or life opportunities. Life opportunities could be education and learning, increasing knowledge, generating wealth, health and well-being. How do you actually turn a series of high-resolution ship drawings into aspects of community well-being? And how do you secure community's commitment to this process in order to convince the funder who is interested in the result of heritage engagement? You might say more questions than answers. Political and democratizing, technological and innovating, entertainment and participatory, equality and equity. So the balancing act of facilitating a community into creation and interaction with a digital resource so that they take ownership of the experience, considering various value drivers and aspiring to demonstrate a change in the life or life opportunity of the community for which the resource is intended. If the process of creating a digital resource, which will register impact and the attention to details, which will make sustainable participation possible. I'll be very interested to hear if you come from parts of the world that I come from, Northern Ireland or UK, where funding is very scarce, where we need to convince our funders that the genius of our innovation and our technology is actually going to have impact on the day-to-day political and economic tensions of our communities. I will be very happy to discuss questions and we can have conversation, but because time is tight, I would like to leave questions for later unless there's anything urgent. To invite Eleonora Lupo to come. Thank you very much.